Welcome back, everybody. Take a look at your screen to see something you may have never seen before. We're talking two unique dog breeds with Judy Ellis and Patty Spittler, ahead of the Winter Classic, looking at lots of different dog breeds, but you've brought two in here that, as I mentioned, I hadn't seen before. Judy, tell me about this guy right here first.
Okay, this is the Sholo Esquintly. We call it Sholo. It's much easier.
And we have the spelling up there if you want to go look it up.
Sholo Esquintly.
It's also known as the Mexican hairless.
Years ago, it was called a Mexican hairless, but now it's called the Sholo Esquintly. Mm-hmm. They come in three sizes. This is the standard. They come in an intermediate and then a toy size.
Okay.
That is more this size.
Oh, hi, baby. Come here. So I recognize this dog from the movie Coco.
Right.
Correct.
Right? And in the movie, that's an animated movie. You can't really tell that he's hairless, but if we can hear, it's full on. It's just skin.
This is the only hair he has.
All right, on the
right
top
here.
Of his head.
Yeah.
Beautiful, dog. And then you have another one here, too, with a lot more hair to maybe even
Yes,
the two.
This is the Chinese crested. They come in two varieties. They have a totally coated variety, which is called a powder puff. Mm-hmm. And then they have the hairless variety, which is naked on the body. There's hair on the top of the head, on the feet, and on the tail.
Oh.
So if you don't like hair on your furniture or in your bed, these make great house dogs for people that have allergies or any problems like that.
And very old breeds, too. These go back centuries.
Ancient breeds.
And I always say, know your breed. This has very different requirements than, let's say, a St. Bernard or a Chihuahua. So investigate, Google, go out to the Indy Winter Classic, talk to the breeders, and find out what it is you need to know about the care. And if you make a lifelong commitment and you know what you're getting, we don't have a problem.
Exactly. Well, I mean, imagine as a breeder, you see that a lot. You see folks who maybe are scrolling through Instagram or Pinterest and say, oh my gosh, I love this
pretty,
dog.
Yeah,
this is so beautiful. Or, oh, we've got to get that dog. And then they actually have the dog, and then they don't realize that he's going to need coconut oil on his body because he gets chapped by the cold wind just like we do.
That's
so
right.
Imagine you see that time and just wish folks would do their research.
Well, you know, all dogs aren't for everyone, but there's a dog for everyone.
Oh.
So you just have to do your research, come out to the dog show. It's a huge show. People are friendly. Mm-hmm. And you can learn about the different breeds. People will, you know, answer your questions. Every dog has its own particular personality, mm-hmm. and you just have to do your research. These dogs don't belong in every home because they do have special needs.
And there you were running to stay in shape. This keeps you moving.
Exactly.
Something else, and I've been to Westminster twice, too, and I've been to the dog show. These dogs, they've grown up doing this. They want to do this. You're not forcing them.
Oh,
No.
It would do, as a handler, it would do you no good to try to force a dog into doing something because it shows.
Yes. Sure.
And so when they get in the ring, they get special treats, they get all this attention.
This is their work.
And they're an athlete. They enjoy it. They're an athlete.
You're an athlete? Are you an athlete?
Say, well, we try not to let him know that. But.
Well, the dog show.
He's all shy now.
He's always in training, this one.
Oh. When is the show? When can folks get involved with it?
February 7th through the 10th. There it is at the state fairgrounds.
Yeah.
And you're going to be there, right, Judy?
I will be there all 4 days. Yes.
And will these two lovely ones be there?
And
as well?
They'll be here too.
Mm-hmm. That's fantastic. Yeah.
Are you okay?
He's sitting like
Did
a
you have a good time?
Too.
And these are known also. I looked up a little bit about the breed. These are known as stalker dogs.
These ones?
Chinese crested. Because once you get them, they won't leave you alone.
They're
have no private time. Everywhere you go, they'll be watching.
Around your neck, in your lap, in your bed. Yeah.
And Pet Pals TV's coming up at 10 o'clock, right,
10 o'clock.
Patty?
And we're going to have more on the movie A Dog Goes Away Home, which features a rescue dog from Tennessee starring in the role of Bella. And we find out about the movie, the dog, and the book as well. That's Pet Pals TV. Thank you very much at 10 o'clock today.
That's wonderful. Awesome. Thanks for coming in, Judy. We appreciate it. And you guys did such a good job. I imagine there's a treat involved.
And I have one more thing.
Real
quickly, on Great Day TV, we talk from chili dogs to hot dogs. The Wienermobile.
See what she did with that. I see what you did with that. Patty's like, yep, we got it. That's true. 10:30, Great Day TV. Marcus will be watching.